Thanks for staying with us. Now on to the world of sport. Top seeds Rohan Bopanna and Aizam Ulhaq Qureshi lived up to their billing and won their first ATP title of the season, now overcoming Robin Haas and Milos Raonic. 7-6, 3-6, 11-9 in the summit clash of the Gary Weber Open in Halle, Germany today. It took the Indo-Pak pair 1 hour and 19 minutes to beat the Dutch-Canadian combination. The win would do a world of good to the confidence of the Indo-Pak pair in the run-up to the Wimbledon Championships. It is Bopanna's third career ATP World Tour doubles title, having triumphed in Johannesburg with Qureshi last year and with American Eric Butorak in 2008 in Los Angeles. Staying with that same tournament, of course, the Indian Express can never be forgotten. Third seeds Leander Paes and Mahesh Bhupathi earned a shot at their third title of the season as they set up the summit clash of the ATP Aegon Championships against the famous Bryan brothers. The Indian Express pair had to dig deep before beating Max Mirny of Belarus and, of course, Canadian Daniel Nestor 6-7, 7-6, 10-8 in the semi-finals. While Paes and Bhupathi are eyeing their first Queen's Club title, Mike and Bob have been champions thrice here. And in the world of motorsport now, world champion Sebastian Vettel's fantastic Formula One season continues. The Red Bull driver grabbed the pole position in the Canadian Grand Prix. And of course, that big race has already started. Vettel seems prominent right through this race so far. Vettel's sixth pole position from a total of 7 races this season. Italian giants Ferrari managed their best qualifying result this season, with Fernando Alonso and Felipe Massa starting the race from second and third spot respectively. India's Naren Karthikeyan has been slotted 23rd on the starting grid. Well, coming back to the world of sport in Chennai, it played witness to a colourful flag-off of the Dakshin Dare Rally organised by Maruti Suzuki, showcasing its third edition. Drivers from all over southern India gathered to the start point at Besanaga Beach in Chennai with a chance to explore Tamil Nadu terrain with a route through Kodaikanal, Coimbatore, Ooty and Mysore, and with a finish point at Bangalore. The first stage will in fact be a speedy circuit track, followed by a dirt track suited to the tyres in use. The total distance of this rally will be as long as 2,500 kilometres.
It's the biggest rally. It's the biggest rally in South. It's called the Dakshin Dare. It's a 5-day event. We are actually driving the extreme category. My driver is Manoj Vaidya from Bombay. Me in Bangalore, Uday Kumar. Let's see, with the rain also going on, with wet terrain. We'll see about the track tomorrow.
This is the first time we are doing a long rally in South India. I don't think there's any other big rally, long distance rally other than Dakshin Dare. So we are really keen to explore all the terrain South India has to offer.
Over to international athletics now, and Tyson Gay had to settle for second place in the men's 100 metres at the Diamond League meet in New York City because of a slightly mistimed dip. Take a look at this special story.
Now, it wasn't the best weather as the 100 metres race finally began after 3 false starts. Gay, the home favourite, came up with a powerful second 50 metres to cross the line alongside Jamaica's Steve Mullings. But look carefully, this is what happened. Tyson Gay had dipped his head ahead just a bit early, slightly before the finish line, while Mullings, who was in fact Gay's training partner, had timed his dip to perfection. Both, of course, finished with the same timing, that of 10.26 seconds.
And finally, from the world of sports to the world of entertainment. After rendezvous with Simi Garewal, the Lady in White is back in a more colourful avatar on Simi Selects, India's Most Desirable. India's NDTV's Beverly White caught up with Simi Garewal and her guest Shahid Kapoor for this exclusive chat on the sets of the show.
Well, I'm certainly a very lucky woman because today I'm in truly desirable company. I'm with Simi Garewal, the lovely Simi Garewal, and the lovelier Shahid Kapoor. I have to say that. The gorgeous Shahid Kapoor. Congratulations, ma'am. It's great to actually have you back on screen again. We've really been looking forward to it. And Shahid, what was it like being on this show, India's Most Desirable? Flattering, obviously.
Yes, very, very, very flattering. And I feel very honored to be here in the company of the wonderful Simi ji. And we had a fun time. I think we had a really fun episode, and it flew by actually. Yeah. So yes, very privileged, very happy. And the show starts tomorrow, so wishing you all the best for that.
Thank you so much. I'm sure it'll have
a great kickoff.
Absolutely. And Simi ma'am has been saying wonderful things about you in all the interviews. What did you find the most charming about Shah? There's obviously lots of charming things about him, but what was the most charming?
Everything. He's the full gamut. You know, he is right from being fun, being lighthearted, being romantic, to being deep and soulful, and to be a full-time entertainer. I mean, you should have seen him.
Yeah.
You will see him in
the
show. How he's dealt with the people, with his fans. It's absolutely incredible how he dealt with Kiki.
You don't know, you'll find out.
Yes, you will find out all about Kiki very soon.
Interesting. And Shahid, what do you think means desirable, really? And is there anyone you particularly find desirable?
Oh no! That's so sweet. I love him.
Well, for all you Simi Garewal fans, her show kickstarts tomorrow. India's Most Desirable is the name of the show. Well, that's a wrap on this bulletin. Thanks so much for watching.